Hello, welcome to the News Digest this week. I'm Vivian Kamsimi. Now, tomorrow, Friday, the 27th of January, the Ugandan National Examinations Board is going to be releasing exams, the PLE exams, to the expectation of parents, children, and schools. In today's segment, we are speaking education. We have the privilege to speak to the UNEB spokesperson, Mrs. Jennifer Kadule, who will be telling us about the mandate of UNEB as results are being released. Welcome, Jennifer.
Thank you.
Previously, as UNEB releases exams, there are cases of malpractice where results are either cancelled or withheld. Usually, the onus is on the parents, the children, and to a certain extent, the schools, to clear their names and have results. Where does UNEB come in?
Thank you so much. Well, first and foremost, as UNEB, it is our responsibility to ensure that we protect the integrity and security of the certificates which we are going to award to these learners. Our mandate as a board is to conduct valid, reliable, equitable and quality assessment of the achievements of learners. And we do this in a professional way, innovative way, but also most importantly, make sure that there's equity, the issue of equity. And for the award of certificates, we should be recognized internationally. So much that if you go anywhere on the globe and you present a UNEB certificate which has been validated by UNEB, nobody is going to question it. So you asked, where does UNEB come in? UNEB comes in here to try and protect the integrity of certificates and the credibility. Because the moment we have malpractice going out there, somebody said, UNEB, Uganda, they are known for malpractice. It is not good for us. The credibility of our certificates will be watered down.
What is your role? Is it only to cancel results and spoil the child's future?
And that is a joint responsibility. Even the learners have got to know that you have a responsibility to protect. We tell them, for instance, copying and being copied from are both culpable. If I copy from you, if you copy from me, both of us are culpable. So we want everybody to understand their responsibility. As a board, we have been stringent enough to make sure that as long as the examinations are still within our control, there is no malpractice.
Talking about cheating, is it more of an insider or outsider job?
It is an outside job.
How do you think schools do it?
That's what I'm trying to explain. External assistance, for instance, is very common. Some of them even cancel their correct answers and they put the wrong answers. Somebody may put the answer for number one and they put it for number two. And the kids go on writing wrong answers. And they are so easy to get. It's so easy to get such learners because, you know, it's last minute and they are being aided or something like that. So that external assistance happens quite a lot. Another form of malpractice which you've seen lately is impersonation, whereby somebody registers and they know Jennifer is going to be doing for so-and-so. So they sit in and they do a paper for the other person. You know somebody who is allegedly bright. They even get secondary school children who are bright, maybe senior two, senior three. We got those cases this year, actually. Those they got for a head teacher registered candidates for other students, and the parents pay for that. And that's where we talk about joint responsibility. Because we find the parents are involved, the teachers are involved, and the learners are involved.
As UNEB, do you track your students, say the very best or those who are not so good? For instance, can UNEB ably locate the students it has issued certificates to in the last 10 years?
That's an interesting one. I don't think it's something we have done deliberately because it's not exactly in our mandate, really.
Whose mandate is it?
That's a research concern. UNEB does research, and we have the National Assessment of Progress in Education Department at UNEB, and they do research on various. They've been researching on various issues that affect policy, and that have been affecting policy at the Ministry of Education in the entire education sector. We could actually interest them and see, can we do research and find out our learners, our candidates, for instance, who get the fours, how do they sail through, how do they perform at senior four level, how do they perform at UACE level. That's an interesting thing. I think it would be interesting to find out how they perform. I would personally be interested in knowing the performance of such learners.
So tomorrow's candidature, what does it look like?
Yeah, the candidature, we had about close to 840,000 candidates, that is for PLE, which is quite big. This was 11% percentage increment compared to last year, where candidature was about 500 something. And out of these, 52% are girls, while 48% are boys, which is a good thing as we're trying to promote the girl child education. Later on, when we go to UCE, it's called more, it's like a balance. We have about 50% girls, 50% boys. Unfortunately, later at UACE, we have the boys outnumber the girls. However, the beauty about this is that the girls who actually sit for the examinations at UACE perform well in the subjects where they take. That is now the beauty about it. But we still need to push more girls to do you at UACE level. But yes, the good thing is they have other options. But at that level, we have fewer girls. At PLE level, we still have more girls coming in. And we want to encourage more parents out there to please, as the term begins, encourage more of your girls to go to school, whether it's at primary level, at secondary school level. Let's encourage our girls to go to school, because once you educate a lady, once you educate a girl, you're educating a nation. So tomorrow, we expect the Minister for Education, Honorable Mama Janet Museveni, to release their results. Of course, the Executive Director will give the statement and give state of affairs, the performance of the candidates, how many performed well, what happened, and all that. Now, PLE has just 4 subjects, so they're easy to track.
If you are waiting for the release of PLE exams, today is the end of the long wait. Tomorrow is the D-Day. Thank you very much for watching this segment. Until next week, the News Digest in the news.